Oligodendrogliomas account for 5 to 15% of gliomas and tend to occur between the 4th and 5th decades and occur more frequently in males than females with a ratio of 2 to 3. The most frequent location is the frontal lobe followed by temporal and parietal lobes, and they arise in the white matter. They rarely occur in the brainstem, cerebellum and spinal cord. Oligodendrogliomas have IDH1 or IDH2 mutation and whole arm deletion of chromosomes 1P and 19Q. The outline of an oligodendroglioma is variable, sometimes they are well defined and sometimes less so, and often extend to the pia. Grossly, the tumours are grey or pink with a gelatinous appearance, and they may contain cysts, areas of calcification, and areas of hemorrhage. Most oligodendrogliomas are WHO grade 2, and the grade 2 tumours are composed of sheets of regular cells with spherical nuclei with finely granular chromatin, infrequent mitotic figures. The cytoplasm is pale, resulting in a fried egg appearance. There may be areas of microcalcification, and the vasculature may have a chicken wire appearance. The grade 3 oligodendrogliomas will show features such as necrosis, increased vascularity, and increased mitotic activity. And these were previously known as anaplastic, but they are now just regarded as grade 3 oligodendrogliomas. And here is the typical histological appearance of a grade 2 oligodendroglioma, and it is composed of sheets of regular cells, and even on low power the perinuclear halos can be seen producing a fried egg type of appearance. On higher magnification, the typical fried egg appearance of the cells in the oligodendroglioma can be appreciated. Another useful feature for diagnosing oligodendroglioma is the presence of microcalcification. In this particular case, unfortunately, there's no microcalcification whatsoever, but you can just about make out a chicken wire pattern of the microvasculature.